post jocundum juventutum, post molestum senectutum, nos habebimus, nos habebimus. Viva Academia, viva professores, viva Academia, viva professores, viva membrum quelibet, viva membra quelibet, semper sint in flore, semper sint in flore.
Please be seated. Ena mana, ena reo, ena hui wha, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice Chancellor, Pro Chancellor, Council members, members of the university, special guests, graduands, families and friends. I extend a warm welcome to this, the third spring graduation ceremony for 2011 of the University of Auckland. This week, the university is bestowing a total of 2,708 qualifications on some 2,450 students. At this ceremony, degrees will be conferred and diplomas awarded in the Faculty of Arts, a total of 348 in person, plus a further 248 in absentia. I am privileged as Chancellor to preside at spring graduation for a third year. The regularity of graduation ceremonies makes them no less special for the university and me personally than for those of you being capped here today, many for the first time. It is also a pleasure to return to the Auckland Town Hall, long our traditional graduation venue, for the first time since 2009. The AOTS Centre, which we now use, has been temporarily captured for Rugby World Cup purposes. Graduation is a festive event rich in history, pomp and colour, with a lively array of contemporary touches. Here in Auckland, our rich mix of cultures and ethnicities can be seen in the striking variety of dress and adornments worn by graduands. Today is one of hard-earned celebration by you, the graduands and diplomates, on your academic accomplishments, and by your family and friends who have encouraged and supported you and who are here to share your success. The university, represented by the council and academic staff members seated behind me, and those many staff who control proceedings with remarkable precision, takes equal pleasure at this hugely significant day for each and every one of you. The University of Auckland is deservedly ranked as one of the best universities in the world. Your qualifications will always serve you well in this country and abroad, whether in qualifying you for a satisfying career or in leading to more advanced study, or simply as a route to personal and intellectual enrichment. In today's ever-changing workforce, you cannot afford to stop learning. So please keep in mind our enormous range of postgraduate opportunities. I urge you, as alumni of New Zealand's leading university, always to remember your alma mater. We depend increasingly on our graduates for support, moral and political, as well as financial. Your advocacy and influence are vital in encouraging government and the community at large to fund universities so they can generate the knowledge needed to drive a productive and competitive economy and to create a full and satisfying life for all New Zealanders. At the same time, philanthropy has become critically important to our university, funding major capital projects, scholarships, and professorial chairs. The crucial contribution of major research universities is not well understood and therefore insufficiently acknowledged. It is inconceivable that a developed, progressive 21st century nation can maintain that status without strong, internationally recognised research-based universities such as the University of Auckland. Our innovative research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth and social cohesion, never more so than in the testing economic times we now face in the wake of the global recession and the devastating Christchurch earthquakes. Universities equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined. Universities need greater investment by government, the commercial sector, and private philanthropy, not less. But that's sufficient for me on the challenges facing this institution. For today is unquestionably your day. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish memories of your graduation in September 2011. Our speaker at this ceremony is Professor Annie Goldson from our Department of Film, Television and Media Studies. She has been producing and directing award-winning documentaries, docudramas and experimental film video for 20 years. Her films have won more than 50 awards at international film festivals and are regarded as both politically engaged and innovative. Professor Goldson is best known for her acclaimed documentaries, which include Punitive Damage, An Island Calling, and more recently, Brother Number One, about a New Zealander who perished in the genocide in Cambodia. She has been president of the Screen Directors Guild of New Zealand, and she received an Order of New Zealand Merit for services to film in 2008. Professor Goldstone gained her PhD at Auckland after graduating BSc from Otago University and MA from New York University. She has published widely in journals and books, and earlier this year she was promoted to professor, and only last week she delivered her inaugural professorial lecture. Professor Goldson.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of Council, members of the University, graduands, whānau, families and friends, kia ora tātou, it's fantastic to see you all. I'm sure there are some familiar faces out there, although you look a bit of a sea to me at the moment. I know many of you will have travelled here, not just from Auckland and around Aotearoa, but from many other countries too, to celebrate the achievements of your sons and daughters. So congratulations to you for raising such wonderful children. And congratulations, of course, to the students who've studied so hard. I've been teaching at this university for 20 years now, which seems quite scary to me. It only seems like yesterday that I began. When I began teaching, in fact, I wasn't a whole lot older than my students, but now I could definitely be their mother, which is something I think about. Over this time, I've watched our students graduate and achieve great things. taking up influential positions in New Zealand and in their home countries, from making award-winning short films and documentaries to assuming positions in cultural institutions or to becoming academics themselves. It's wonderful to see that they've benefited from an arts education, and I know I speak from our department and the faculty in congratulating you. We're very proud indeed. I've watched the student body change quite rapidly in the last two decades. The university is a much more culturally diverse place today, and it has made the classroom much more lively with some genuinely interesting exchanges. I have found that these changes have made my teaching more enriching as Kiwi students and I learn more about the world through our international students' experiences, and I know the latter learn from us about life here in New Zealand. It's almost a cliche that we live now in a world increasingly mediated, defined, it appears, not just through media such as film and television, but through the internet, Google, Twitter, Facebook, etc. It is a very recent history, and the fact that these technologies are so present today always surprises me that they were only invented, if you like, such a short period ago. Digital technologies are reshaping our disciplines from classics to gaming, shifting the way we teach, learn, and how we understand the world and each other. Nonetheless, although we in media studies stay abreast of these developments, which of course are bread and butter to us, I think the ability to think critically, to research and write, to express our thinking, to analyze, remain crucial skills, perhaps even more important in this day of new technologies. So these are the research and critical thinking skills that I believe a Bachelor of Arts at this university or an advanced degree too can really assist you in your future life. We know it's not all good fun being a student. There's always the pressure of deadlines, the time and effort that needs to be put into study, and I applaud you all for having aspirations and for following them. I know it's all too easy to slump down in front of television and watch the All Blacks, particularly at the moment, and that keeping up one's study takes discipline and commitment. But it is those kinds of commitments learnt at universities that can assist you in developing a life that's more meaningful, engaging with the workplace, with society, with culture and the arts, that will give you a richer life, but will also allow you to contribute to the world. And of course, there are the fun times of being a student, and now you should really let your hair down, exchanging ideas, getting involved in campus and Auckland life in this lovely city that we live in. So congratulations once more, and now it's time for you to celebrate and party. Kia ora.
Thank you, Professor Goldson, for a most interesting and insightful speech. This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. At this ceremony, the Pro-Chancellor Ian Parton and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
Thank you, Chancellor. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Arts, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon an Associate Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Dr. Barnes, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the conferment of a degree or award of a diploma in the Faculty of Arts. Graduate Diploma in Arts, Andrew Everard Fairgray Allison. Song Peng Ye.
to the degree of Bachelor of Arts. Jaleesa J. Adams. Natalia Searle Adkins. Awra Alawi Saeed Ali Ahmed. May Yusuf Ahmed Al Sharaf. Zahira Ali Hassan Ali Ahmed Al Anfus. Fatima Abdul Ghani Ismail Ali. Minal Manisha Begum Ali. Fatima Abdul Nabi Marhoon Jazim Alsari. Khadija Saeed Ali Hashem Ahmed Al Wadai. Jiwon An. Richard Gary Anderson. Javan Esetera Arthur. Kayan Aslani Seysan. Adele Carita Nadia Alva'i Key. Claire Diane Bailey. Erin Narissa Bailey. Tayapa Rukupo Vincent Bailey. Jerome Buck. Shreya Bakshi. Ayobami Hoyindamola Beckley. Elizabeth June Beach. Fanga Malama Pauline Bentley. Elizabeth Judith Beskin. Charles Shepherd Bidwill. Alexandra Kate Billing. Charlotte Aroa Martina Blacklock. Timothy William Bonner. Misty Rose Marima Briggs. Kimiora Jacqueline Brown. Hanin Anwar Ahmed Abdullah Rahman Dukkamal. Mele Tofahima Buktafe. Zoe Roisin Bunting. Alistair David Harrison Butterworth. Judy Coraline Sylvia Kellingham. Ralph Henry Carswell. Neha Sopan Chowdhury. Mas Aida Sheikh Mansour. Megan Shemali. Sandy Ishwan Chin. Aline Eating Chun. Yuen Kwang Chen. Hoi Kit Chan. Jiwan Choi. Kyung-mi Chu. Francis Carlyle. Sarah Elizabeth Clapson. Sarah Louise Clegg. Lisa Terry Cohen. Michaela Erin Cole. Miriam Joy Collins. Nadine Mara Convery. Kendall Ann Conway. Bradley George Louis Coward. Catherine Julia Cullinane. Shika Anjanita Das. Henry St. John Davis. Lucy Elaine Davison. Catherine DeSeaton. Martha Angjob Dung. Heather Jane Derbyshire. Cora Eve Deverick. Benjamin Daniel Jane. Alicia Riparata Dodd. Carissa Ann Donnan. Lance Roger Donnell. Laura Evelyn Dower. Emily Rachel Durham. Max Joseph During. Abdullah Samir Abdullah Ahmed Ibrahim. Amanda Calderwood Elmsley. Moitoto Adrian Faasolo. Saha Faharat. Ashley Erica Findlay. Jessica Jane Fitzpatrick. Zoe Amelia Fitzpatrick. Robert Wayne Fleet. Cedric Benjamin Folau Moitui. Jenna Lee Tapu Foliola. Virginia Ruth Frankovich. Jessica Fu. Blair Noni Gamblin. Jessica Rose Christine Giesler. Amy Lee Gordon. Dawson Peter Fodiva'a Grace. And Thea Harland Grant. Anthony Dean Gray. Melissa Yasmin Greenwood. Sandy Guan. Panchali Vidya Gunaratna. Elka Hafkamp. Satina Natasha Halaholo. Amber Patricia Hallamore. Jung In Han. Yong Shi Han. Adam Francis Graham Hand. Kristen Adele Hansen. Adele Elizabeth Hunter Higgins. Robin Crichton Hill. Jonathan Zhuangya Xu. Jared Ian Holton. Saeed Ibrahim Ikram. Savelina Yosefo Amor. Ipshita Ipshita. Cherie Michelle Jack. Stephanie Jane Jackson. Hyunmi Jeong. Jessica Jones Langley. Hyunji Ju. Ashley Jean Kenrick. Zainab Yahya Abdullah Kamis. Sarah Lasalani Kiernan. Yesung Kim. Jihun Kim. Jihaek Kim. Jin Yong Kim. Song Ju Kim. Natasha Frida Kinsey. Noriko Koyama. Ashneel Kumar. Shan Shan Lily Lai. Osane Hilary Lata. Soloimalo Lomo. Erica Jane Lawn. Briar Elizabeth Laurie. Karen Lee. Soo Hyun Yi Lee. Natasha Ann Layton. Ioane Leota. John Leulu. Joan Juan Leung. Kaijun Liang. Melissa Kylie Linton. Rosemary Sean Littler. Odine Lawrence. Daniel William Lucas. Jia Nawal. Fa'amanu Ma'ava. Kevin Francis Machine. James Robert Brooke Mackley. Liam Nahina Joseph McGurran. Danielle Kelly Maika. Zainab Saeed Salman Jabba Tahir Majid. Rida Noor Malik. Tuka Abdul Jalil Saeed Mahoon. Ruta Masina Lupe. Angela Joanne Matheson. Cecilia Hukisia Matoto. David Daniel Matthews. Megan Angela MacArthur. Philip Edward McLaren. Callum John McMillan. Jean Malatoisi Meredith. Queenie Mikaire. Donna Marie Mickelson. Christina Charlotte Milligan. Natania Kelly Kareen Milne. Charlotte Amelie Jane Milton. Siali Tafa Oe Vai Mone. Robin Idris Morgan Jones. Eva Rose Moronga. Brianna Ashley Moses. Chaitra Mysore Sridhara. Susan Maria Nash. Philippa Fiona Niels. Nicole Sherry Nelson. Takwan Crystal Ng. Ka Ying Nai. Moitu Marina Nakio. Andrew James Nichols. Gareth Edward Nixon.
Give the Pro-Chancellor a rest. Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Nick Hall on trumpet, accompanied by James Tibbles, will now perform La Rejouissance by Telemann.
Thank you.
the music aficionados will know that George Telemann wrote the five heroic marches. That's the first one from that piece, but it is actually a very heroic piece of music, and I thought it's beautifully played, the trumpet with those clear notes played by, it's played solo and accompanied in the way it was by James Tibble. It's just a real pleasure to listen to. Can I ask you to show your appreciation again to Nick and James? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Roger France, Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who within their faculty have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Associate Professor Crosthwaite, to present graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Christian O'Brien Malloy. Lauren Elizabeth O'Sullivan. Salote Fuikavamoa Otu Taha. Sabrina Samantha O. Sharon Joy Overall. Waini Nuosala Marjorie Palele. Filiami Kumipalu. Akana Lynn Patel. Rachel Amnibai Paul. Zachary Stephen Penman. Amandine Isabel Pascal Pettit. Vigilia Pillay. Henry Llewellyn Pritchard Poor. Nimaroto Alexander Power. Eloise Camillo Pulido. Morgan Bree Reed. Seung Mi Ro. Khatun Abbas Ibrahim Muhammad Saleh. Aaron Nicholas Santry. Angela Louise Scott. Billy Elizabeth Sargent. Jason Lee Sito, Senior Scholar in Korean. Janice Jyotika Sharan. Regan Michael Sharp. Lauren Jane Sims. Siato Sione Fa'amo. Mohammed Shiraz Sirajur Rahim. Talangi Sitivi. Elki Somansiu. Francesca Jane Skelton. Elton Rikihama Smallman. Michael James Smith. Peter Keith Smith. Nathaniel Fa'afuina Solomona. Michael Sun. Anna Elizabeth Stanton. Elizabeth Jane Stevens. Jessica Anne Stevens. David James Stewart. Laura Kate Stewart. Rebecca Stirrup. Justin Robert Stoddard. Shonal Sumit. Sophie Grace Swan. Samantha Mary Fine Tangatoatama. Huishi Paula Tan. Laurel Heather Tofuata. Catherine Patricia Taylor. Tung Fei. Jordan Danielle Thompson. Tiria Naya Tiria. Eliza Tufala. Cedric Eddie Tuiavi'i. William Siali Tuitu'u. Aitaivo Kara and Denise Dana Sione Tukuitonga. Laura Grace Turner. Sneha Venkatesh. Anthony Paul Vlug. Katerina Volkova. Kirsten Marie Wagstaff. Simon Pereira Waite. Kristen Jean Walls. Wendy Riwen Wong. Christopher Richard Warren. Meg Margaret Claire Waring. Candace Leslie Weir. Sally Rose Costa Weir. Rebecca Jean Weihongi. Pauline Melrose Wilderspin. Hirani Orlina Nicola Winikeri. Kate Alexandra June Wintle. Matthew Boyd Woodley. Patrice Christine Wright. Ping Ping Wu. Ye Chia. Jia Xin Jung. Ruby Patricia Zimmerman. Adam Anthony Zulornik. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Conjoint, Sarah Elizabeth Bulkley, and a Bachelor of Science. Samantha Vernley Chia, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alexander Michael Davidson, and a Bachelor of Laws. Gabrielle Elise de Jong, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Dylan Patrick Gedge, and a Bachelor of Laws. Talia Mary Affleck Koifman, and a Bachelor of Science. Emily Amala Marinkovic, and a Bachelor of Fine Arts. Alexandra Mary Price, sorry, Marie Price, and a Bachelor of Science. Deepika Sharma, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Liana Eiling Thomas, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Wing C. Sarah Yip, and a Bachelor of Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts with Merit. Doreen Onama-Inga in Development Studies. Valeria Openko in Development Studies. Wahyu Wijayanto in Development Studies. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts. Nafisa Jahanmadarani in Screen Production. Jasmine Nouri Al-Rais Al-Khattab in Film, Television and Media Studies. Emil Tuati in Geography. Anna Saini Tuinukoafe in Political Studies. Postgraduate Diploma in Language Teaching with Merit, Julie Marion Harvey. Postgraduate Diploma in Language Teaching, Oan Wang. Postgraduate Diploma in Translation Studies with Merit, Erin Cordelia Costello. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with First Class Honours. Miranda Kossar in Film, Television and Media Studies. Peter Andrew William Dixon in Political Studies. Matthew John Harnett in English. Hannah Elliot Ferns Nielsen in German. Hannah Sukwa Reynolds in Film, Television and Media Studies and a Bachelor of Arts. Nicola Leanne Robson in Ancient History. Valentine Watkins in English. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with Second Class Honours First Division. Gada Hassan Hebashi in Education. Melissa Andrea Moore in Anthropology. Alexandra Barclay Port in English. To the degree of Master of Arts with First Class Honours, Luke Samuel Anastasio Headley in Screen Production. Sarah Mary Anderson in Philosophy. Ella Catherine Arbery in History. Catherine Louise Errington in Political Studies, University Graduate Scholar. Giordana Antonietta Featherston Santusoso in Linguistics, Faculty Graduate Scholar. Andrew Lawrence Flores in Anthropology. Mm-hmm. Louis Desmond Girdelin in History. Margaret Ann Carfaru in Anthropology. Anna Klein in English. Maria Vanessa Olivares Manolo in Language Teaching and Learning. Gina Patricia McFarlane in Anthropology. Philip Robert McKibben in Philosophy. Tracy Elizabeth Macquarie in Psychology. Rebecca Leanne O'Leary in English. Justin Matthew Pickett in History. Daniel Michael Satelli in English. Pooja Singh in Psychology. Claire Rachel Slarko in History. Jasmine Katie Taylor in Psychology. Susan Ann Thorpe in Ancient History. Priscilla Tu in Mathematics. To the degree of Master of Arts with Second Class Honours, First Division. Nalini Lovanita Chand in Education. Sally Noel Hewlett in Development Studies. Dagwoo Kang in English and a Bachelor of Arts Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in English. Li Meng in Linguistics. Sha Sha Li in Film, Television and Media Studies. Rangi Maria Dorothy Mules in Anthropology. Niharika Puri in Psychology. Shirley Patricia Wallace in Anthropology. To the degree of Master of Arts with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Maji Balagayagalit in Development Studies. Ismot Ara in Development Studies. Fan Xuan in Language Teaching and Learning. Takahiro Nakata in Language Teaching and Learning. To the degree of Master of Arts, Fa'afia Leopo O'Apapo in Development Studies. Johnny Chung Hung Hui in Education. Demi Valka Patrick in Philosophy. Oh. to the degree of Master of Creative Writing with Second Class Honours First Division, Siegel Buttle. That was Sigal Buttle. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours Second Division, Sui Baohui in Language Teaching. Luis Alberto Perez Rosales in International Relations and Human Rights. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies, Hongbin Gao in Language Teaching. To the degree, to the degree of Master of Public Policy with First Class Honours, Rebecca Jane Moore Bollard. Chancellor, Professor Wainwright, Head of the School of Theology, will present further graduands in the Faculty of Arts.
Graduate Diploma in Theology. Elizabeth Maureen Bald. John Thomas Glynn. Linda Mary Murphy. Son Jin Hee. To the degree of Master of Theology with First Class Honours. Deborah Ellen Anstis in Biblical Studies, University Graduate Scholar. Lorna May Travis in Practical Theology.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have pleasure presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Dominic Nigel Andre in Sociology, University Doctoral Scholar. Dominic investigated the everyday lives of a community who live and work on Auckland's Karangahape Road and who are heavy users of drugs and alcohol. This was carried out with a view to improving their lives through the drug treatment court process. Judith Joy Hammond in Political Studies, University Doctoral Scholar. Judith investigated ways to accelerate the socialisation and democratisation of international society by the people, so that in the future, in addition to states, individuals would also be recognised by international law, creating an inclusive and fair international society and law that might secure perpetual peace. Mangala, Maya, Silke, Johanna, Sonia Calling in Comparative Literature. Angela investigated how writing that combines factual accuracy with literary versatility forces us to consider the elusiveness of truth as a valuable resource for the reviewing and reimagining of ourselves, our history, and our social communities. Chi Lee in Language, Teaching and Learning. Chi investigated the motivation of Chinese learners of English in a foreign and second language context with a view to understanding L2 motivation more fully as a dynamic and situated phenomenon. Her thesis points to some important differences in Chinese learners' motivation in these two contexts. David Jeffrey Lindsay in Political Studies, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. David investigated the way the New Zealand Parliament handles moral issues, focusing specifically on the set of issues treated by Parliament with conscience votes. His findings will be helpful in better understanding contemporary politics in New Zealand. Liangni Liu in Asian Studies and Chinese, University Doctoral Scholar. Liangni investigated the ongoing cross-border movements and re-migration intentions of New Zealand's recent migrants from mainland China. Her research has revealed that the home of recent Chinese migrants is perpetually on the move, and their transnational movements are continuous and open-ended. Billy Jane Lithberg in Art History, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Billy examined Ngātu, or Tongan decorated bark cloth, made since 1980 through the performative process of layering plant-based and or synthetic materials and their use and display in Tongan and Western contexts. She discussed various uses of Ngātu within Tongan communities, the impact and implications of the introduction of new materials, and what happens when it moves into museums and gallery collections for display. Ellen Margaret McRae in Italian and Translation Studies, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Ellen carried out a detailed comparative analysis of the translation into English of the writing of two Sicilian authors, with the aim of demonstrating the ways in which the act of translation assists and shapes readers' understanding of other cultures. Arapera Naha in Māori Studies. Arapera investigated the link between te reo Māori and Māori identity and considered how Māori communities felt about the promotion of and support for the learning of te reo by non-Māori. Her study provides an opportunity for the Māori community voices to be heard, explores the impact such a strategy might have on them, and offers concerns and solutions that might be used to inform Māori language policy. Peter William Wensaw in Theology. Peter investigated the theological impact of word changes in Te Piho Patanga or Aotearoa Māori language liturgical texts. He proposed strategies and tools to further develop the management of liturgical experimentation. Yiga Zhang in Film, Television and Media Studies, University Doctoral Scholar. Jiga investigated media reform in Guangdong Province, China, during the 1980s and 1990s. He found that the emergence of a partial but increasingly open public sphere in journalism and broadcasting in that region serves as a forerunner of democratisation across China. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Arts.
On behalf of the university, I now invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And this would be the perfect opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they have achieved their qualifications today. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori and then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programs.